In this video, you will learn few interesting features of FreeCAD, and I will show you this on the example of this solid. First, we will create the basis of this model, and then we will create another part of this model. And finally, we will combine both parts so that they form one model. And we will use part workbench and part design workbench to create this model. Let's start by creating a new project in part design workbench. And select create circle and select XY plane as the sketch plane. First, make sure you have these options selected. And select create circle and draw a circle so that the center of the circle lies on X-axis. If you move the cursor over the X-axis, it will be highlighted. And now, if you click the left mouse button, the center of the circle will be placed on the X-axis. Okay. Draw the second circle in a similar way. Okay. And now select constrain diameter, select this circle and enter 60 millimeters as the diameter of the circle. Okay. Then select this circle and enter 40 millimeters as the diameter of this circle. Now we will determine the distance between the centers of the circles. Right click to cancel constrain diameter command and select this point and select constrain horizontal distance and enter here 40 millimeters. Okay. Now I want these circles to lie symmetrically about the y-axis, but in a way that the distance from this point of this circle to the y-axis is the same as the distance from this point of this circle to the y-axis. And for this I need to create additional points, select create point, and place one point on this circle and the other point on this circle. Okay, right click to cancel this command and select this point and x-axis and select constrain point onto object. Okay, and do the same with this point, select this point and select x-axis and select constrain point onto object. Now select this point and y-axis and select constrain symmetrical to place these circles symmetrical about the y-axis. One of the basic rules of creating 3D models in FreeCAD is that sketches cannot intersect. Therefore, select trim edge command and select these circle fragments to remove them. Now select create slot and draw the slot so that its points lie on the x-axis. Okay, right click to cancel this command and now let's define the dimensions of the slot. Select constrain horizontal distance, select this line and enter 50 millimeters. Okay. Now select constrain vertical distance, select this point and enter here 70 millimeters. Okay. Right click to cancel this command and now select this point and y-axis and select constrain symmetrical. Okay, the sketch is fully constrained. Click close to exit the sketch and select path operation and enter 3 millimeters as the length and click OK. And we have created the first part of the model and we need a similar sketch to create the next part. And we could create this sketch from scratch, but we can also create this sketch from an existing sketch. And to use an existing sketch, you must make a copy of it. And to do that, go to the Model tab, expand the Path operation, select Sketch and press Ctrl plus C. And here uncheck Auto Select Depending Objects, select Sketch Only and click OK. Then press Ctrl plus V to paste the copied sketch into the project. Let's hide the model for a moment. Highlight the path operation and press the spacebar. And let's turn on sketch visibility, select the sketch and press the spacebar. This sketch is a regular sketch and we can edit it. Double click the left mouse button to edit the sketch. And in this sketch we only need the internal geometry. Let's remove the outer geometry, but using the selection box, in this case we'll select all the geometries and we only need to remove the outer one. Unfortunately, today I don't know any other way than selecting each geometry individually. Okay, click outside this geometry and just select external geometry and press delete to delete them. And okay, click close to exit sketch, and now we need to offset the sketch to create the geometry to make the second part of the model. And we will do it in part workbench. Select part workbench and select this sketch. Select part to the offset and enter 3 millimeters here and click OK. And at first glance, this geometry looks correct, but they are two separate geometries. Now, if you select this geometry and select the extrude command and add a 10 millimeters extrusion, OK, you will get something like this. And that's not quite what we want. Let's undo this operation and double click the left mouse button on this operation to edit it. And to get the geometry that will allow us to get the required shape, check the fill offset option, click OK. Select this geometry and select extrude again. And for the length along, enter 10 millimeters and click OK. And as you can see, the second part of the model has been created. Now turn on the visibility of the first part of the model. And what you should pay attention to is that the extrusion of the second part of the model was made from the bottom level of the first part. If you want, you can move the second part up by 3 millimeters. And to do this, select the second part in the operation tree. Expand the placement, expand the position, and in the Z-axis, enter 3 millimeters. Okay, now the height of the second part measured from the top level of the first part is 10 millimeters. Okay, but they are still two separate solids. And to combine these solids into one, with Ctrl key pressed, select both solids in the operation tree, select this solid and select this solid, and then select union operation and OK. And we have one single solid. But some geometry spoils the view here. I will expand all operations. OK. Sketch visibility is turned on, select it and press spacebar and OK, it looks better. OK, now we can change the color of this solid. Right click here and select random color. OK, and if you want to choose a specific solid color, right click and select appearance. And here as shape color, you can choose any color for the solid. Okay. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel.